I can make your hands clap.
Whoever you are, wherever you race, hit the track like a champion. The YZ250F and YZ450F Monster Energy Yamaha Racing Editions, only from Yamaha.
Hey everyone, welcome to this week's Yamaha Checking In With. We've got Davi Millsaps, who's a sight for sore eyes. You're back here in SoCal. I think you're training Carson Mumford part-time.
Riding coach.
But more importantly, there's a bike in the back of your truck, dude. Can you tell me what that's about?
Which one?
Let's talk about the gas Casper.
Well, I was supposed to do the Moto Fight Club race in May, and they ended up canceling it. And so I hit up Jeremy at AEO, and I went and bought it for the race, and then they canceled it. So I'm like, all right, well, I have it. Might as well build it up and then start riding with Dane. So I'm bringing it here this weekend, or this week, and then I'm going to try to ride at Cahia with Dane on the weekend.
Oh, nice.
So that's, yeah, I know Mark did the suspension on it. I got the PC pipe, flow pegs, ODI, and X-Trig. I'm good to go now, man. Oh, and I got W wheels, so throw some of the plugs in there.
Why did you choose a gas?
I like red.
New and shiny?
I like red. And there's no bikes out right now to go get. And, you know, it was either get or buy an old Honda or like a newer gas. And and I went the gas route. Because I had been on it, obviously, you know, I know TK, I know Scuba, and I know Carlos. So I have that whole realm over there to where if I need anything or, you know, something happens, I can contact them and ask them.
Okay, so rumor has it you are making a return to Loretta Lynn's to face off against old MA800.
I heard that he was going to race Loretta, and I'm like, oh, man, that'd be amazing to go back and race 800 just for old time's sake. And for me, just to mess with them, you know. Like, obviously, we were amateur rivals the whole entire time, and I had nothing against Mike anymore. It's been so long, but it would still be fun to line up next to him, just to go race him.
Yeah.
Now, this year probably not, but maybe next year.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, maybe next year.
All right. So, you know, I know that you retired when you had a pretty bad concussion.
Yes.
Have all those effects gone away? Because I know that we chatted for a while and you said you still had some concussion syndrome.
Yeah, when I did the interview with you on your podcast, since then, dude, I've been through hell and back still with it. And all of a sudden, just, shoot, it had to be maybe 2 months ago, I started noticing a big turn for the good and started to actually come back around. And I've noticed a lot more of up and up. I have, let's say I have, you know, a week or two of actually really good weeks, and then I might have like 1 or 2 days of bad days, but versus where it's like one day on, one day off, one day on, one day off. Now I have good weeks, and, you know, and it's, I can see the light in the tunnel, and I'm getting closer and closer to it. So, you know, diet and vitamins, honestly, are probably the biggest things for me with the gut to brain health.
Really?
And, okay, you know, I've done a lot of research into the gut to brain health when I hit my head. I had to figure something out. I couldn't live like that. And obviously a motocrosser, I don't think any of us have patience.
Yeah.
And I've waited 3.5 years to start to feel somewhat normal again. And that was a long time for me to wait.
What was the worst of the symptoms? Was
it suicide?
Oh. Yeah.
Unfortunately, that was depression. Yeah. And for what reason? You know, obviously you've known me a long time, and I was always like a happy-go-lucky, like obviously very out there, and that stopped almost instantly for me.
Yeah.
So for me, it was just getting over why do I have those? I knew I was having them, I just couldn't stop it. I knew I was in a bad mood, I just couldn't stop it.
Yeah.
So that was probably the worst for me. Knowing that's not me, but I can't stop it.
Yeah, it's crazy, man. Like, people don't understand how serious that stuff is. I mean, obviously with Dave Mira.
For he's CTE, but for me, I don't have that. You know, according to all the doctors, I do have micro concussions, but I don't have all of them. Was the deal? And they're like, you are apples and oranges away from CTE. And I'm like, at least that was good news for me. You know, if not, then bring on something. I don't know.
Yeah.
So.
Well, I'm glad that the dark thoughts are gone.
Yeah.
Already.
Yeah.
Because you have a beautiful family.
Yes.
And, I've gotten to interact with Dane a little bit.
Yeah, and, Dane's cool.
Dude, you have gone head first into mini dadism.
You know, I lost a bet to him, which is why he has a dirt bike.
Yeah.
And it's not like I'm, crazy headfirst into mini moto dad. It's because we don't ride all that much. He does races. We do, the works races. And now we're doing, he loves the Moto for Kids stuff. So he does that. And because Mason Wiggins does it, so they're obviously really good friends. Mm-hmm. And then, we did the one Swapmoto last year. I don't have time and we're all over the place. It's hard to come to California for a day to do a Swapmoto. I need like a whole weekend thing. And
well, we have the mini major coming up.
Yeah, that's so far out of his reach. Like I said, we went when my father-in-law went to the hospital for his transverse myelitis.
Yeah.
He didn't ride for 2 months at all. So we do those breaks. He doesn't ride for a month. Or he'll race, or he hasn't ridden since the last Moto for Kids, which was what was that 3 weeks ago? Mm-hmm. He hasn't ridden one time. So. He does it. He loves it. I get it, but it's hard where we live to do that, unfortunately.
Yeah. So. Yeah. So you are living in Lake Havasu.
Yeah.
And for those that don't know, you bagged Miss Supercross.
You love that.
I just love it. You're married to Miss Supercross, dude.
You love that, dude. No, I'm married to Brittany.
Brittany, but retired life is it everything you thought it would be?
Or don't ever do it.
Really?
I mean, I miss it. I miss having the purpose of a reason to be in shape, a reason to goals. Get on a dirt bike and goals. And I miss the competition. Yeah, I can ride my dirt bike whenever I want, but I don't, it's not like that.
Yeah.
And I do miss it. All the days that I look back now, it's like, man, I wish I would have done this. It went by so much faster than what I really thought I was going to. 15 years went by really fast. But I'm enjoying it now because I get to spend time with my kids, hands down,
mm-hmm.
and be a family man. But for me, being out here now with Carson, gives me that purpose again to where mm-hmm. this morning I was up at 4:30 to drive out here to California. I had a purpose, and then I know what I'm doing this week. It's kind of like getting back into routine, getting back into into a rhythm, but I don't know, for 3 years I sat on the couch just losing, besides actually losing my mind, I was losing my mind. And I'm like, dude, I need something, I need to do something. And I got the phone call and I'm like, yes, thank God. Mm-hmm. So it just happened to be perfect timing.
Yeah, so Carson reached out to you then.
Yeah.
How is that going so far?
Obviously I worked with him for a week and a half before he got hurt. And then he took a few weeks off. And then I was back out here last week and watched him ride, and then so today's day six back on the bike.
Mm-hmm.
So it's just getting back into it, but I enjoy it. Mm-hmm. He's a good kid, a lot of talent that he doesn't know he has, so I'm trying to get it out of him.
Nice. Look to see some big things from Carson. I've known him since he was a little kid.
He's still little. Still little at heart.
All right, so you got a shiny new Specialized S-Works Epic in the back
of
your
truck.
Are you a big cross-country guy out there in Havasu?
I don't like the all-mountain bikes. I don't like the, it used to be the camber, but I guess it's just stump jumper now, right?
Yeah.
I'm not a big stump jumper fan. I have my Levo, but I think I've ridden the Epic for so long that...
Is this an Evo Epic?
No, I have an Evo Epic at my house.
Okay.
And
because it's got a dropper on it, right?
Yeah, I put the dropper on.
Okay.
Just because when you start to use a dropper, and I went back to the stiff seat, I'm like, God, I need the dropper back.
Yeah.
So I bought the dropper. But yeah, Mark, Dom, and Kevin at InCycle definitely, they've been taking care of me for ten years now.
Wow.
And there was a lady there, Lala, that I was working with. Jason was there before that. Then everyone kind of dispersed, but. For me, I love the cross-country bike. I have a road bike in the back of my truck mm-hmm. as well from them. So I can't get away from it all the way. I got to stay in shape. I have a half Ironman I'm supposedly doing in October.
Oh, yeah?
So, yeah, Scott Simon talked me into it.
Oh, okay.
So I don't know. I don't know why I listened to that idiot. But but I'm doing it. It's a good thing, though, because he's going to struggle as much as I am.
Yeah. But you still like the pain, the pain cave.
The suffer, man. It's something that you're just never gonna lose. Yeah. You know, that's why I can't. I love riding my e-bike. I do, but it's not the same. Yeah. I'm not gonna go, oh my god, like, yeah, I want to ride the e-bike. I would grab my Epic any day of the week over my e-bike, just for that simple feeling, like I'm doing work.
Yeah.
And right now, the way I look, I need to do work. So
you look better now than you did when you came to the race.
Easy.
No.
When I came to where?
When you came to the Glen Helen race.
Oh yeah.
Yeah, you've cut since then.
Oh yeah, I was feeling real good at Glen Helen.
Well, hey man, it was awesome to catch up with you. Always a pleasure seeing you. And looking forward to Loretta's 22.
Me too.
Thanks, buddy.